The moment had arrived. From being spurned by eSports royalty to having my brain zapped by an addiction therapist, via PC bongs, Lamborghinis, and robot costumes, I had finally got here. The World Finals.
We're at Seoul World Cup Stadium, the biggest stadium in Korea, and it's here where the League of Legends World Championship is happening. Everyone we've met has been waiting for this moment. If you're a gamer, this is the most inspiring, most important event in all of history. There's gonna be entire cosplay teams who spent weeks preparing their costumes, tens of thousands of screaming fans cheering for who they want to win. But most importantly, only one team is gonna go home crowned the League of Legends World Champions.
On stage, the costumes looked amazing. But while we were backstage, the downsides to wearing a 12-foot suit of armor quickly became obvious.
Did he draw the short straw and have to wear that? Can he walk forward or just sideways like a crab? All the teams are here, CSL, Spiralcats are here too. So this is the moment we've all been waiting for. That giant costume back at CSL's cosplay house is now gonna come to life with all the parts assembling. It's probably the biggest, most outrageous, most unlikely and impractical cosplay costume, well, in history. So the giant dragon thing, Zarm, just fell off while everyone was watching. I guess that's one of the downsides to taking cosplay to this level.
When the competition's this fierce, the only way to win is to go bigger and bolder than every other team. It seemed like the Korean cosplay scene was witnessing an arms race of epic and irrational proportions.
Everyone knows Cow Guy, like everyone is taking photos with him. When I interviewed him, I just thought he was a random guy dressed as a cow. He still is, but to these people, he's also more than that.
And there he was, with a whole new entourage and a whole new do. It was Hai from Cloud 9.
Hey man. Oh, sorry. What happened with the Spiralcats? Did you ever end up hanging out with them?
What?
With the Spiralcats? Did you ever end up hanging out with them?
Yeah.
Nice. Cool.
It's... When did you want to do things? Later?
Yeah, sure. If you're around, that could be cool, yeah.
I'll be somewhere. I don't know where, but I'm pretty easy to spot, so.
Pretty easy to spot? Yeah. All right, cool, man. Well, thanks. Thank you. Bye. So hard to get like 1 minute with Live from Cloud 9. There's like 40,000 people all waiting to get in.
By the time we entered the stadium, it was already swag o'clock. With enough swag being thrown out into the audience to feed an entire army of LOL fans.
You didn't get a swag. You can get the swag at their game too. You can get the whole swag. So don't worry about that and have fun. Thank you.
You. If we didn't get swag the first time round, there's gonna be another couple rounds. So that's a load off.
As the fans took their seats, the countdown to the opening ceremony began. Nothing could have prepared me for what was about to happen.
Are you ready to begin?
Yeah.
I couldn't believe the scale of the whole event. Before each team walked on, they were introduced by a dramatic video segment that was packed full of expensive CGI graphics. After a Korean drum ceremony, we were treated to a performance by an American rock band called Imagine Dragons. They're one of those groups that are somehow really famous, but you'd never meet anyone who actually listens to them.
This is a computer game that we are all gathered here to watch. A computer game.
Once the opening ceremony came to an explosive end, the players sat down, chose their characters, and the competition began. Samsung White versus Starhorn Royal Club for a prize of $1 million.
Again, we'll see if Royal Club can get under the skin of Samsung White.
After sacrificing so much of their young lives, having defeated the best teams from every corner of the world, these 10 players were locked into a struggle that would decide the future kings of a game played by 70 million people.
Here he comes. He's in stealth.
There's the alert. They know he's there. They don't know who he's on. He eats Uzi right away. Looper's going to be able to give a little bit. Dandy gets the heal and he flashes out perfectly. Here comes Pawn from the side.
Samsung White had the upper hand from the get-go, swiftly beating Starhorn in the first two games. Smelling defeat in the air, Starhorn made a bitter last stand and managed to pull a game back.
Comes a clean up team. He's gonna let it go. The flash over, but Uzi will get it. He's gonna go towards him. Jumbo kill. Uzi down for Uzi.
Start of the Nexus, and Royal Club do the impossible. They take game three against White, and we're gonna be going to game four. The series is still alive. They have the emotions to keep it going. It's something that led them to the win over OMG. They have the longevity. They have the mentality to stay in these best of five series and play for the long haul.
But their luck had run out. As hard as they fought, in the end, they were no match for their Korean counterparts.
They're going to focus in on the Nexus itself. And Samsung White are the 2014 world champions.
What a sight.
After almost 4 hours of unbroken concentration and high-speed gameplay, Samsung White had done it. They demolished Starhorn in 3 out of 4 matches, letting Korea keep its position as the world's esports powerhouse for another year.
This is a victory that's going to go down in history as the biggest and the most covered, with the most lights, the most fireworks ever to happen in the whole world of esports.
The cup hoisted in front of the home crowd, pleased with the victory, pleased with the games, and the games were absolutely amazing.
The closest I could get to meeting the newly crowned world champions was through another strictly controlled press junket.
Can you tell me about the emotion of winning the title here in Korea, in this stadium, in front of 40,000 people?
우승을 했지만 좀 뭔가 아쉬워요. 이게 뭐냐면은 저희가 경기하느라 정신이 없어가지고 많은 환호를 더 느끼지 못한 게 좀 아쉬운데 근데 이번 우승이 한국에서 우승한 거라고 생각하니까 더 이게 뭔가 뭐라 해야 되지? 기분이 좀 설명을 잘 못 드리겠는데 좀 기분이 좀 남달라요.
롯컵 상금은 어마어마한데 상금은 어떻게 쓰실 거예요?
상금을 그냥 일단 다 놔둘 생각이고 뭐 보통은 다 적금하겠죠. 막 저장해 두겠죠.
I finally got the chance to ask the one question that had been answered by everyone except the players themselves.
So this is a question for the whole team. Do you guys consider yourselves to be professional computer game players or athletes?
운동선수가 아니고 저는 네.
저는 운동선수라고 생각해요. 육체로 하는 게 아니지만 마음으로
저도 운동선수라고 생각해요.
저도 운동선수라고 생각합니다.
저는 그 가운데 있다 생각해요.
I wanted to know, do these guys consider themselves athletes or not? to everyone else, they already were athletes. They were focusing on how they were athletes, what amazing moves they were doing, how their strategy brought them to victory. Is it athletics? Is it not? It's its own thing entirely, and it's something that's very much born out of today.
In the 6 years since it was created, League of Legends was able to fill a stadium with 40,000 people, but there were 27 million more tuning in live from home. That's more than the audience of that same year's NBA Finals. Before it took over the world's stadiums, esports was already connecting hundreds of millions of people across the globe, and with the internet's colossal reach, it's now growing at a rate that televised sports may never catch up to. There have always been people who chose to escape the monotony of the real world by immersing themselves in fantasy. The difference is that those people used to be called nerds, but now they're called stars. Hearing the cheers of 40,000 people echo throughout a World Cup stadium made it clear that gaming was finally getting its Woodstock moment. Rather than a marginalized subculture that parents refused to understand, esports is the newest part of mainstream culture. And before long, anyone trying to ignore its global significance will be lying in its wake, wondering how computer games took over the world.